I began as a graphic designer. As part of my work, I created many film symbols for ad campaigns. During that period, I happened to be working on the symbols for Carmen Jones and Man with the Golden Arm for Otto Preminger. And at one point in our work, Otto and I just looked at each other and said, why not make it move? The audience involvement with a film should really begin with the very first frame. You have to remember that until then, titles had tended to be lists of dull credits, mostly ignored or used for popcorn time. So there seemed to be a real opportunity to use titles in a new way, to actually create a climate for the story that was about to unfold. Drug addiction, and the symbol, that is the arm, in its jagged form, expressed the jarring, disjointed existence of the drug addict. Now, to the extent that it was an accurate and telling synthesis of the film and the ad campaign, these same qualities came with it into the theater, and of course, with the addition of motion and sound, really came alive and set up the mood and the texture of the film. Walk on the Wild Side, I used a cat, a creature we've probably stopped really seeing a long time ago. Now the challenge was how to restore our original view of a cat when it was new and strange, and to transform it into a pervasive presence, which was at the same time faithful to Nelson Algren's story of New Orleans street life.